What are you expecting out of this game? As
we probably Clubhouse. Oh wow, it was Clubhouse.
You're a
genius. What a guess from me. That is just
to see whether or not the Chiefs go for something cheeky here. I like this from Wildcard. They're about to isolate. Oh, simulator! That's worthy. Oh, they're straight down. This is absolutely massive, Raven. What a call from Wildcard. They're already on site. Chiefs, what hope do they have in this round? Maybe digital, but it's already plant time. Oh my god.
Yeah, yeah, really, really quick control here of Church does mean that even under that gunfire, the plant can go down. Chiefs are trying to fight back. It's got a 2-2 versus 2. Milo and Pat left to try and hold this down for Wildcard to such a successful entry.
Society's got two nades to play with. Is Digital watching a light? Fine! There we go, my god!
I don't know whether my eyes just deceived me or not on that Kennel's wall. I think maybe I was... Oh!
What's the time like there for Vinny?
It's going to be a very critical gunfight right here for Geo. If he loses this, it's going to be tough for Wildcard. And he does come out on top.
Oh, very big. Emo Rin opens up his bank account as well as now Geo starts to poke and prod around the side a little bit more. How's the trade, Digital? And all they have to do is play for time. Worthy says, no, thank you. I'll find myself a second of the round. Just like that. It is the Chiefs that are off
now,
to
this is going to put so much pressure on Chiefs. It's hard to hold Church with this wall open.
Oh,
Worthy
God.
And God Legion combined. Fantastic job from the Chiefs. Wildcard fight back, but it's all on Pat.
Ooh.
He's going to have to do it, Manic.
Certainly is, but two really nice shots has given him an opportunity here. Fisher guy with a cheeky little whoop.
Up front, up some aggression here, and this could get a little hectic as the peak goes out. Pat hits a shot.
God Legion just waits for the jump in, turns at the wrong time. Wildcard swarm the side. They're starting to suffocate them. It's in default. Do they have the ability to hold? Oh my god. Digital nearly making it around the corner in time. It would have been but a second in it.
Wildcard starting to mount up their attack. Selma doesn't hit a single thing. And now, with only 5 seconds left, Wildcard have to go in. It's Worthy who should be able to deny it.
Oh, Milo's fallen out. It's all over. The round's done. Chiefs take it 5-1, Raven. And what a way to do it.
I think we've figured out the Chiefs kryptonite, and it's called Consulate. Oh my god, what is going on here?
Vinny with a double. Trying to find more Chiefs with a huge oversight, sending it into sight and completely being just thrown around like a rag doll. It's Worthy. Of course it's Worthy to give them an opportunity. But Vinny steps up massively in a round that could not have been bigger.
I think this is going to be tough here, Manic.
Yeah, that's a nice way to start. Grenade and that smoke is going to slow them down significantly. Trying to push on in. If they find the kills, it still is doable. But my goodness, Wildcard. They shut it down with seconds in it.
40 seconds left on the clock here, Manic.
Oh, that's the one that they needed. That is Milo. That is the Roma down. Vinny. Just so cautious, but look at that. Digital goes down. God Legion quickly trades. Fisho doubles down, and Geo is left to save the day. He can't do so. And the Chiefs, they take all 3 points away, Raven, in a really decent showing from them.
Yeah, it was a really good match overall.
Clubhouse once again. Xenox, what have you got to say?
And this could be a massive opportunity, Raven. He can hear the footsteps. He's going to be able to deny both players. Absolutely outrageous for a way to start. Oh my god. Oh, that is disgusting.
Absolutely outrageous from ED. Oh, Dino catches a cheeky little rotation. Look, they might be able to do this. A bit of information now being given across to the side of 7th Heaven. And just like that, Soufflé will close out with the final two. Wow, oh wow. What a way to start for 7th Heaven.
Knights under a lot of pressure too. Josh has actually been down and finished off, but trades coming through is really important for the Knights just to stay in touch with that. And they go bang. They've given themselves that man advantage right now. And Soufflé certainly not feeling strong down below. And Knights have stormed side here, Manic.
They certainly have. Juicy just playing with death at the moment. Soufflé.
He is relatively stuck, and this is an opportunity where he probably should have got aggressive, but didn't.
Oh.
And that's where the Knights have beautifully capitalized there. Some really good trades forth.
Pika, he starts to figure it out. That's an unreal C4. It does not connect though. And Juicy swings from the back of blue to find the kill. Looking really good from the Knights so far, Raven.
They stand to have a 5-1 half right now. They've got that opening pick. Opening double, in fact, Manic.
Wow.
Triple, it just keeps going. This is incredible.
Gaining speed, gaining momentum, and gaining size. Haywood finds a double kill in the round.
Pika.
He would have to hit some outrageously large shots to make this work.
And Knight's really well spread out as well. Using the utility against 7th Heaven, Salt in the Wounds. That is a dominating 5-1 half from the Knights on attack on Clubhouse.
But they're going to be careful. Oh, oh, this is massive. Oh, no. Oh, how does he fix that? No way Sage covers his backside. Certainly has. Looks like it might just come to its conclusion. An early conclusion at that. Dino being the last nail there. And my goodness, the performance of 7th Heaven. Without the mute, without the mozzie, without the vigil, this is looking so damn clean.
Knights have certainly got this in the box seat. Pika, they know his position. Dino's taking out ED. Manic, I think this is it.
It is well and truly it. Knights making a statement here. 7-1 victory, 7 rounds straight. It doesn't get much more clinical than that.
Gate. No Clubhouse today. It is the Oregon Rock.
Even in the first round, that has not been the case. Elevate playing quite measured at the moment, but they're finding kills.
15 seconds left on Aguirre. Still above. Oh, he finds him in the back. That's Hajime. Shot in the back by Colas. And Producer Boom now inside a red time. Need to come up big here late into the round. DCH going to be eliminated in the hallway. That Diffuser has not gone down yet. There's only 1 second on the clock. Time's going to run out here. Q confirm win the round. A minute and 20 seconds left, guys. I mean, Elevate's going to be careful here that they don't overdo this.
Rotero Drain will finally head in, take down that deployable shield, forcing Hajime's hand. He goes for the vault out, but does not find anything. DCH with a triple in this round. Onigiri gets in on the action, and there we go. It's over. It's flawless for Elevate. They finally cleared out Small Tower and got the job done.
14 seconds left. Again, it's red time. And again, it's these two teams mostly healthy, but Q confirmed down to two because Lycolas is on the floor. Big opportunity for Producer Boom to go Boom himself here. Roltini covering over towards Freezer. Lycolas is officially gone. And right now, it feels like all of Q confirmed might be officially gone too. They are getting slaughtered here on Oregon. Producer Boom going for that roam and that flank, and he will get an opening kill. He does. And every single time, it is Elevate that wins out late into the rounds, and it's happening again. Lycolas is low. You can't expect too much from him. And atop the freezer stairs, Producer Boom springs out. He does get the kill. But at what cost? He lost Lycolas, and now it's a 1v3 in red time, and they know where he's coming from. Elevate are on a different level here on Oregon.
Elevate looking so good.
Three drones left, 45 seconds, opening pick. Napu once again, Elevate. Although there's two back, pretty quick. We just lost four players instantly. Blink and you miss it. BG Man is having a big game. Maybe that's what the BG stands for. Q confirm, obviously on site, but healthcare struggling. BG Man, he's on to double digits.
We're trying to hold back that push alongside him, but also deep over towards Trophy. They go deep though, however, Roldini finds one. DCH goes big at the top of white, and now Roldini needs to keep stacking on the pain. He has the diffuser to play with, but not much time. Hits the shoulder of Sapa, doesn't quite find the kill. 15 seconds left.
DCH,
but it's
perfect! Absolutely perfect! Rotated back over to security. Still actually have a lot of drones available. This was a... Wow, what is Hajime doing?
Sapa is an annoyance. Still over towards the back stairs. BG finally shut down. Almost wins yet another swing.
Just peek left, get that player in freezer. You get full control. He almost missed the player in laundry. Yeah, that's an easy kill. DCH, of course. He had to watch sight. He couldn't watch behind him. They'll be able to overwhelm the clash now. Q confirm. That's much better. Producer Boom, though, is honestly producing a pretty decent game here.
This will be tough.
10 seconds left, drops down. You said the Al is going to be in a good position. Doesn't quite find what he's looking for. In fact, it's Hajime from behind. Big kill, but there's only 3 seconds. Red time, like Lycolas, he's got the diffuser. Has he got any time to get it down, though? No, he does not. Elevate win the round. And they win the match. And they will return to their rightful place here at APAC South.
This Clubhouse, another one, guys. Now,
that has been pre-placed there by Joe. Now, Specker takes control of logistics, wins against Jordan despite being swung on.
Yeah, big advantage now for Order. Joe, though, can't be counted out, but he does lose his tag team partner. In Speak Easy, he's a pretty good player. Jack Dad's going to go for that diffuser. Oh, he gets spotted. Joe's played this perfectly. He's got a quad. And he's got time. Bailey has to stick it. He's been pinged. That is going to be a round win for him.
Being available, very, very strong. The position, especially after her rework, as Bailey finds the first in blue. Invictus have faltered over towards blue, control obtained by Order.
Oh, beautiful headshot from Bailey. Eventually went down really easy and didn't have much of an impact. Luna now inside a church, does get the elimination onto Bailey. And Hysterix has got Diffuser down now in front of him. Still 3 versus 1 though, with Jackdad getting Hysterix. Luna inside a church. Red time. Can he have a Joe moment?
Luna could have sent out an Nitro, but there we go. Shut down by Specker. It's a good solid round end there for Order.
And a big game between these two teams. Oh, nice shot from Bailey. He's done it again, Guz.
That weakness is being exploited. Oh, and there we go, Nate. A clean shot with 5-5-6 to find one. And now they can activate. Once again, blue control will be taken and they're just falling apart.
Joe gets the flush as well and gets the second one too. Hysterix dies and Joe maybe he's almost doing it again. For a split second, Guz, I definitely thought that it would happen once again.
They will not make the playoffs for the second stage in a row.
Oh, Specker. Oh, just skates away there from Joe.
Perfect.
Turns around and finds the pick. They are at the main disadvantage.
Yeah, and they don't have these hatches opened either. They're just going to be lambed to the slaughter. Nico finds two very quickly. That's the round over. I mean, it was never going to be a possibility for Invictus. I mean, yeah, eventually got this kitchen hatch open, but they had no motor control. They were all coming in through mains. That was flawless from Order, but a little bit bewildering from it.
Was pretty dire position early round. Now Nate gets aggressive and there we go, gets the kill onto Rafters. The Diffuser is dropped. He has a Nitro Cell that he can use down below. But Jordan is putting up a fight, trying to get that Diffuser back. But there we go, the Nitro Cell onto Jordan. Leaves Luna in the 1v1. It's potentially winnable. They find the shot. No, Bailey wins it out with the Org. It was close. But the setup works out for Order.
What is that shit? We're heading into that red time as well. Joe's taken off the board immediately. It's a 1-for-1 trade. 4 versus 4. Nico's low, but it's Nate. It's Becker. It's Jackdad. It is Order getting it done when it matters the most in red time, in the clutch. And Speakeasy, he's not on that gun anymore. He has to stick to Diffuser. He's eliminated by Jackdaddy. Nothing that Luna can do. Order have made it into the top 4 with now 1 playdate to go.
Top of the standings, the 2 tie teams. Elevate and QC at 12 each. Knights also in contest for that number 1 spot at the end of next playday. That's game that will, I guess, potentially confirm which team we will send straight to the major. And look at the mid-table as well. 8-8-8, 7-7, Raven. You just cannot split Apex out.